Hey guys, so today we're going to work on an alcohol marker tutorial for my character Naomi. We're going to be covering quite a few topics. Hopefully they'll be helpful and inspiring to you guys based on a really insightful comment that I greatly appreciate requesting more tutorials with a variety of skin tones. So definitely going to try to step that up. You're completely right. I do have characters who are of different ethnicities than myself, and I do draw them in my comics, but you guys don't get to see that on my channel. So I need to bring them and share them with you guys. So we're going to be working on darker skin tones today using alcohol markers. Hopefully that's helpful to many of you guys and inspiring to others. And in later videos, I'd like to do some watercolor tutorials with a variety of skin tones as well. So we're going to start off. I want to start off kind of simple, focus on like a pretty bust. We're working in the Denik Inktober notebook that was sent in my Art Snacks Inktober box. It handles markers pretty well. Let me show you guys an example. It handles markers pretty well. So there are some blending issues, and when you're dealing with darker skin tones, blending becomes much more noticeable if you're having trouble with blends. So we're gonna talk about that in a little while. But first, I'm going to attempt to draw a pretty bust of Naomi, because she is a pretty girl. So something sort of soft and romantic in appearance. And I'm gonna do that in time lapse, but I want you guys to pay attention to the sort of shapes I'm using to build up the head and the features, because that is another tutorial that I've been meaning to do for a really long time and I keep putting it off. And I do mention doing it. So I'm going to go over that in time lapse and hopefully you guys can follow along. So the next step is to start inking, and I want to ink with something that is Copic proof. Now, when you're inking, you do have several options to choose from for alcohol marker proof inks. You can use my favorite, the double-sided Sailor Mitsuo Ida. Those can be a little hard to find though. You can also use Sakura of America's Pigma brush pins here in FB, MB, and BB. You can use a Sakura of America brush pin. And as long as they're Pigma, they should be alcohol marker proof. So you can use different colors if you wish. You can use Copic multiliners. You can use Prismacolor brush markers. So you have a pretty good selection, but I think I'm going to actually use a combination of, since I'm inking over graphite and graphite has a tendency to show through when you use color inks, I think I'm going to use the Pigma brushes and the Sailor Mitsuo Ida. So I'm going to start off by inking her name at the top, and then I'll just sort of work my way down. And I'm going to do that in time lapse. If there's ever something that I do in time lapse that you guys would like to see in greater detail, and I don't already have a video covering that, and I do have quite a few inking videos on this channel, please leave me a question in the comments, or if you need clarification on something, just let me know again in the comments below. I'm here to help you guys, so, you know, your feedback is important to me. All right, guys, so we have our basic inks here, and we need to allow these to cure for 24 hours. That way they won't smear when we add the alcohol on top of them. So I will see you guys tomorrow with that. But before we go, we do need to talk about something that is important when you're considering darker skin tones. With lighter skin tones, you can rely on the white of the paper to sort of cover up some of your mistakes, because the colors you're using are so light, it's hard to differentiate between super pale peach and you know, paper white. With darker skin tones, having a good base color is really important. You want to start with a pretty much saturated skin tone, because that way it's not going to look streaky or blotchy or weird. So handling darker skin tones is a little bit different from handling lighter skin tones. So something that I've noticed, and one of the reasons why most of my field tests are for Kara and not for Naomi, is that most sets, when you purchase markers in a set, they might have one okay Caucasian skin tone, and you can kind of fake with that, but they usually have zero acceptable darker skin tones. The browns often are just not right for rendering people. So I do tend to fall back on rendering Kara, since she's a little bit easier and she doesn't require as many skin tones in order to look good. That isn't to say that darker skin tones aren't worth rendering. They're most certainly worth rendering. And I do believe I have a post on the blog recommending colors for darker skin tones to help you guys get started. I'm just sort of mentioning this because if you're working with a limited set, you may be struggling to achieve the skin tones you want with that set. And I'm just trying to let you know that that isn't your fault, that most of these sets do not have good colors for skin tones, and then you may have to purchase some additional colors open stock in order to get the result you want. I personally think that's well worthwhile. I think that is important to do. I just wanted to give you guys the heads up. So I'll see you guys tomorrow, and we'll continue working on this bust of Naomi, the 14-year-old teenage girl character from my comic 7-inch Kara and Kara's best friend. So I'll see y'all tomorrow. Hey guys, so it's been 24 hours, and while I was actually waiting, I went ahead and I swatched several colors from a few brands that'll be helpful as base colors, blush and lip colors, and final shading colors. So for base colors, you have a lot to work with, and for some of the lighter base colors, they also work well as, for some of the darker base colors, they work well as shading colors too. It really depends on the skin tone of who you're rendering. So I'll go over them with you guys. You have in Blick 051, which is Latte. In Copic, you have E71, Champagne. E70, Ash Rose. E34, Oriental. And E23, Hazelnut. In Ranger, you have Latte. In Prismacolor, you have PB95 Light Tan, PB65 Sienna Brown, PB90 Walnut, and back again in Copic, E17 Reddish Brass. For blush and lips, I find these colors work really well. In Copic, you have E04 and E17, Lipstick Natural and Reddish Brass, respectively. In Blick, you have 036, and in Prisma, you have PB152 and PV169. Henna and Tuscan Red. And I'm sure there are other colors that work. This is based on the collection I have and the colors I'm familiar with. For final shading colors, we have Copic E27 Africano, E47 Dark Brown, E59 Walnut, E79 Cashew, and E49 Dark Bark. So the next thing, and I'm sorry about that hanging cable, I have a new lavalier mic. And the cord is really long, but hopefully the vocal quality is much better. So the next thing we want to go ahead and do is we want to go ahead and erase our line art from the paper. And now would be a really good time to go ahead and use your drafting brush. I'm going to use my Tombow Mono Eraser. And when you're erasing, you want to make sure you get everything that was on the paper, because graphite can ruin your alcohol markers. So you do want to be careful. And I just realized, now this will work. There was a color I wanted to grab. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to apply an all over wash of alcohol color. You can do that using a spritzer bottle if you like, but I'm going to do it in this instance with a, actually I really could do it with a spritzer bottle. What do I have? Sure, why not? So I'm first going to apply a wash all over with R20 in a Copic wide, and this is one I filled myself, and I have a video tutorial on how to do that. And we're gonna do that all over. And this is gonna do a couple of things. Well, it's running kind of dry. It's going to influence the color we put on the page. It's also going to make it a little bit easier for us, because instead of trying to render a dark skin tone from this unnatural white color, we're going to be rendering it from a pink that's much closer to most skin tone bases. And I don't, oh, I really do need to refill this. I don't always do this. It's kind of bad news when the marker is dying out on me. Would be great for a plaid, but we're not doing plaid. Gotta put that in my pile of markers to refill. So I think next I'm going to go ahead and spray using Wild Plum. Now, sometimes I'll use masking frisket and mask it off, but I think what I'm going to do is I'm just gonna use, maybe not, because that'll wick through. If I had a heavy piece of paper, I could use a heavy piece of paper. Yep, I sure do. Sort of block off areas that I really don't want affected. And this is, come on, there we go. Just a bottle of spray alcohol ink. So it's a regular bottle, and I filled it with Ranger Wild Plum. Oof. And unfortunately, cheap spray bottles have a tendency to drip more than spray. So we can kind of soften up that harsh square. And if it gets on your hand, you can just use an alcohol wipe to clean that off. So I'm gonna let that dry, because it does, it has puddled in some areas. And we'll get back to it in a minute. All right, so for the most part, that square kind of harsh shape isn't gonna matter, because that's going to be pretty much entirely covered by alcohol marker. And I softened those edges when it wouldn't be. But I'm gonna go ahead and take a slightly darker pink than the one I initially put down and darken some areas around Naomi. I'm gonna have a heck of a time rendering those pearls, but we'll figure it out together. That's not a big deal. All right, so we've got our background. Well, no, I guess I can still do a little up here. It's funny how that Wild Plum makes a color that is very much not neon, Sardonyx R21 in Copic, look kind of neon. All right, let me put those out of the way. So we're gonna go back over here, because this was not just made to help you guys, although it was made to help you guys in, you know, to an extent. This was also meant to help me decide what colors I wanna use and in what order. So, I think I want to start with Prismacolor Sienna Brown, but, so I'm going to grab that, but I want to apply her lipstick first. So let me grab my Sienna Brown. No! Dang it! So while I was fishing for my Sienna Brown, my Alvin art bin, no, not Alvin, my art bin marker satchel tipped over and all the markers spilled out all over the place. And this happens pretty regularly. And I know I reviewed the art satchel a while back, and I'm bringing this up because it happens a lot, like a frustrating amount of a lot, and is definitely something you need to be aware of. If you're gonna take my recommendation from that time and get that marker satchel, there is nothing in them to hold the markers in. So if it tips, everything goes everywhere. Anyway, we're gonna do a couple of things right now. First, we're gonna grab a colorless blender and we're going to push back some of the color on certain areas like the eyes and the pearls and the teeth. That's kind of an important one. Now, that'll make some of those purple spots sort of blend out a little bit. See how it just sort of like... Actually, let me zoom real in for y'all. So it does tone them down to an extent, but it also, how do I put this? Makes that this plum pink a hotter pink, which isn't necessarily a good thing. But it may make it something that's easier to color over and to deal with. So I'm gonna go ahead and handle all the pearls in time lapse, and then I'll get back with you guys. So I think I kind of like the tie-dye effect. I'm gonna spray this with, oh, come on. Hey, spray. Little bit of rubbing alcohol. And for those of you who aren't familiar with this trick, rubbing alcohol is not quite as good as colorless blender, but it's a lot cheaper. So you can use it to blend out larger areas like that. And of course, we have to let it dry again. But hopefully it'll break up some of those areas where the ink just dripped, and not in like an attractive way, but just dripped. So I'm gonna let that dry and get back to y'all. All right, so that dried. The next thing I want to do is I want to go ahead and start applying blush. And I like doing that kind of early because it just seems to work better, if that makes sense. So I'm going to start with E04 Lipstick Natural in Copic. And we're going to zoom in. And when I apply blush and lipstick, I definitely do the lips. It's true. And it's okay if I over apply because this color is barely going to be visible by the time I'm done. So basically clown lips for poor Naomi. And sorry, that's my Skype. That's my Skype again. I thought I turned off sounds, but you know, Skype knows best. Then bait eyeshadow, very 80s eyeshadow. Then the nose, and then we want to do the cheeks. And the reason I do this way, I apply the blush first, is because on darker skin tones, sometimes the blush, the color you would want to use, the influence you would want to use for blush, like you don't want to go in with a red, right? Well, that can push your darker colors back. Because the way alcohol markers work is, unlike watercolors, you're pushing layers towards the back. See, like that? Pushing color to the back of the paper. So you definitely want to apply your lighter colors first. And since blush is sometimes a lighter color on the darker skin tones, I just go ahead and apply it first. And if that doesn't make sense to you, honestly, for a long time, it didn't click with me either. And I would go to put blush on Naomi and it would just look really weird because I would put it on top of her skin tone the way I would with Kara, because Kara has lighter skin. So we've got it. And that looks kind of silly, right? And that's okay if you think it's kind of silly, because hopefully, all things going well, it's gonna work in a little while. So next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to apply a little bit of this darker color, definitely to her lips. Those Denik spirals are getting in the way. And I can always reapply this, by the way. And then a little bit under her eyes. And I'm actually not going to blend this because I'm going to add her skin color next. And that's going to blend this for me. And for her base skin color, I'm going to use Sienna Brown. I used to use Mushroom and Champagne in the past. Those are too light. This is a much better color for Naomi. So we're gonna go ahead and apply Sienna Brown all over as a good base coat. And I've never actually used Sienna Brown in a skin tutorial, at least as a base. So this might not work. We're gonna find out together though. Isn't that exciting, guys? And I chose it because I usually watercolor Naomi. And when I watercolor her, she's got a lot of warm tones, warm brown tones in her skin. I mean, you can have cool brown tones like sepia and some umbers, and you can have warm brown tones. And both of them are applicable for skin. It's just that with Naomi, I wanted a warm tone. I thought that would like kind of push this like friendly teenage girl appearance. I guess I don't get to talk about Naomi too much. So it's cool to get to like hang out with her basically. So this is sort of telling and not showing, but I have a little bit of a writing dilemma coming up. And I am on the fence because I don't know how people would feel about this, whether they would feel like this is a derail or if they would enjoy getting to know Naomi on a more personal level. And I would like to do a chapter about just Naomi without Kara, really. See, there's like a lot of stuff kind of going on in Naomi's life. Like her parents just got divorced and she moved from New Orleans to this little town her dad grew up in, Louisiana. And she just started at a new school and she moved into the house her dad grew up in. So, you know, she's got a lot going on already, and she's in ninth grade. So she's just starting high school and, you know, she's switching bands, like she's an oboe player. So she's switching from one band to a new band. And the group of girls she kind of gets in, kind of becomes friends with, they're kind of mean to her. But they're kind of also the first people to talk to her. So it's like, well, does she stick with this group of girls she doesn't really like? Or does she just kind of like wing it on her own as a freshman at a new school in a new town? So I kind of want to do a chapter just about Naomi. And I think there's like a lot of meat in the chapter, and I would be excited for you guys to get to know her better. I spent a month in 2014 or 2015 just doing drawing challenges of Naomi every day. So I got to know her really well. And I want to share some of that with you guys, but I'm not sure if, cause this is right now it's a print book. Like if this was a webcomic, I would just do it. But it's a print book first. So I'm not sure. I really ought to just do it. Cause like, as I was telling it to you guys, I was like, this is stuff that if I was reading, I would want to know this. Like she's not really a side character. She's one of the two main characters, and she's got stuff going on other than just Kara. And I don't want to divert away from the main story too much. I don't want it to seem like I'm stalling, but some of the things that happen to her in that chapter are important, and they would they do affect her behavior later on in the story. So I thought that might be a good idea. And I'm sure most of you have not read volume one of Seven Inch Kara, so you're like, what are you talking about? Ah, you should read it. It was supposed to be a webcomic this month, and things, life happened. But it's, I mean, the pages are done. The pages are done. The pages are lettered. The first book is in print. Like, it's out there. It just needs to be a webcomic now. Anyway, so that's the first layer of Sienna Brown, and I think it actually worked really well for Naomi. As you can see, all that weird-looking blush got super pushed back. So we're going to go back in with Tuscan Red. And reintroduce it. And you guys can kind of see why. I hope you can see why I did that first. Because I think it creates a smoother blend without pushing the color back. That was one of the problems I was having when coloring darker skin tones is I would apply a base coat, like I would do with Caucasian skin tones, and then I would apply the blush, and the blush would often either look really like overly heavy or push the color back too much. So I've been experimenting with it. It's different than I would do it in watercolor, but that's okay. I really want to do the blush bigger. But then I got to worry about blending it out. And you want to work while the paper, at least for the techniques I'm showing you guys, you want to work while the paper is still pretty wet. I know you guys are like, that's weird doing it that way. Hopefully it'll work out, because it blended down more than I wanted the Tuscan Red to blend down. So I need to reintroduce it. And I recommend if you find colors that work for you, you write them down. Okay. Now we're gonna go back. Oh, no, I wanna use the brush end. Back in with that sienna. And I've seen people refer to this as like the domino mask. So basically you wanna draw like a superhero mask in terms of shading around your character's eyes. Because that's where the eyes are sort of recessed in the face in general. And then the next thing I want to do is I want to start delineating, like adding some of the angles to her face. She doesn't have a particularly angular face. She has a very a soft sort of sweet face. But I do want to start blocking in the shadows. And start sculpting her ears. I want all of that to be in shadow. Up there. And if you work while it's still wet, it sort of blends into itself much easier. It's also more prone to soaking through the paper. So I have it's a junk piece on the other side. I used it earlier today for a brush demonstration, so I don't care. And sort of reinforcing certain areas. And really, I try to use each individual color multiple times to build up tone. I find that it makes for the smoothest blends, and you can actually get a lot of color depth out of a single marker. So for those of you who have smaller collections, you know, this is a really, really try to just practice, experiment with layering your markers and seeing how many different colors you can get. And there is still some, there's some areas where it does look, unfortunately, a little patchy, which I'm not excited about. Eventually I'll get good enough at this. I'll find the right combination of skin colors for Naomi where I can avoid having that sort of patchiness because I don't care for it. Blocking in areas of shadow. And if you watch my watercolor videos, I talk about contrast being important, and building up contrast, form, and tone in markers is also important. Marker and watercolor are very similar in terms of just sort of how like the light plays off of them. Markers do have the benefit of being a little more vibrant, and that's because they're dye-based, and dyes are typically synthetics. So they're not going to be light fast, but they are going to be brilliant. She looks a little bit like My Sweet 16 Barbie, but I was sort of thinking about like the sort of stuff teenagers wear for like festival wear, that kind of stuff. And like the whole, in the summertime, the whole boho look always seems to come back in. It's like one of those perennial favorites. So I thought it would be pretty cute. And I have like a whole Pinterest board of clothes for Naomi, which makes it easier when I'm trying to pick out outfits for her in the comic or in these sort of like little standalone illustrations. So you guys can see we got a lot of really good depth out of just one marker. I mean, really, okay, two, three even. But honestly, I feel like the lipstick natural, you can't even see that anymore, or natural lipstick, whatever. You can't even see that anymore. So I'm going back in with that Tuscan red, sort of reinforcing her blush and her lips. And next, we want to start doing some shading. And I found two more colors that work really well for darker skin tones in terms of shading. Eggplant and cocoa bean. Wow, that was stupid. I should have put something underneath that. I'm so careful about protecting that beforehand, not even thinking. And I try to keep notes for myself as I find colors that I like so I can refer to them again and again. I mean, isn't that kind of the point of experimenting, is to find things that work for you? Africano doesn't seem like it's going to make as much of a difference as I would like, but eggplant and cocoa bean actually seem like they would work really well. So, and remember, you can blend some of this out with your sienna. Side of the ears. And some of this I am definitely going to blend out, and some of it I'm going to leave it as is. And you don't want to blend everything out into a smooth gradient, in my opinion. I know there's some people whose styles do that. Because you're going to lose that contrast. And to me, the contrast is what makes watercolor and alcohol markers really seem to pop. I do actually want to darken her whole neck a bit. So I'm going to reapply that eggplant later. And in case you're wondering, I'm doing this on the Denik paper that came in my Art Snacks Inktober. And before you guys say, that's not fair, we don't have access to that. You can do the same things I'm doing on Plate Bristol. In fact, you might have better luck with it than, not that this is going poorly, but I use Plate Bristol a lot, so I'm a little more familiar with it. And the Denik paper doesn't blend quite as well as Plate Bristol does. You can use like Strathmore 400 or 500 series Plate Bristol. You can use the Plate Bristol that comes in Strathmore's visual art journals for these same techniques. You can use cardstock. I mean, I use markers on all kinds of things. I probably shouldn't, but for some of the stuff I'm doing on this paper, I don't want to recommend it, the other papers to you guys, because different papers absorb ink differently. So you see how we do have like a bit of a blending problem up there with Naomi? And if we were dealing with Caucasian skin, so basically if we were dealing with a very light E00s, E52, that kind of stuff, you could blend that out if you really wanted to with a colorless blender. With some of the browns, they shift colors into like weird oranges, which are not, you know, not human skin colors. So you can actually blend out, we could blend out with a lighter brown than the sienna brown. So we could blend, we could try blending with latte, but we're gonna lose some of that warm brown. We could try blending with oriental, but we're gonna lose some of that warm brown. My hazelnut's kind of out of commission right now. We could use light tan, I think, and then go back in. And this is gonna be one of those, don't necessarily do what I do unless it works, and then you can do what I do, but if it doesn't work, I don't want to be responsible for your demise. Okay, so it's light tan, and we're doing it over on our shoulder because it'll be a little less noticeable. Because basically, the reason streaking happens is it's an uneven saturation of color in the paper. It's not quite lightening up the way I thought it would.
And when you're testing out a technique, you definitely want to test it out in the same sort of scenario you intend on using it in. And sometimes that means testing it out on your character as you're painting them. Well, I can at least use tan to sort of add some additional color to the darker areas. It's not quite working the way I wanted it to. That's okay. In fact, it's kind of a weird color. It doesn't quite layer the way I wanted it to. And next, we need to find a good shading color. And that can be a BV or a V depending. I'm grabbing a V, which is eggplant. We're going to see how eggplant does. And I want to pop something underneath to act as a buffer for the ink so it doesn't just bleed through onto her face. So since we already kind of affected this card, we're gonna slip that underneath there. And I think that's actually gonna be too light. And like we talked about earlier, with colors that are too light, it's going to push the color back. Oh, I need to grab something darker. Let's see. Aubergine. I think I've used aubergine with Naomi before. Guess what? Aubergine and eggplant, same thing. It's an eggplant. So it's funny that we've got eggplant, which isn't even eggplant. Oh, y'all can't even see that. Eggplant, which isn't even eggplant colored, and aubergine, which is more so eggplant colored than eggplant. And then let's see, we've got slate. Slate might be too cool. So we're gonna do aubergine and slate, but slate only in the areas that are the coolest and the most shaded. And you can still see some of the spots from the background, but it's much less noticeable. It almost looks like really cute freckles on her. And Naomi doesn't have freckles, but that would be really cute. Then I would have two characters with freckles. I mean, two characters in the same comic with freckles would be a little much. I wanna go a little redder. So I'm grabbing henna, which is a beautiful red color, to be honest. And I don't even know if I need to use slate gray at all. So we're gonna grab a blue next. This is B32, pale blue. Hopefully it's not going to be too dark. And when coloring eyes, I like to do like a curved top half. I've seen a lot of digital artists use that. A little bit around the edges. And then her teeth, because there's a lot of pink in there. Blend that out a little bit. Okay. And her eyes are like kind of a weird yellowish green. They're hazel, really, but it's like a yellowish green to green to brown. Ooh. I will stick with just greens, though, with a brownish green in there. So, using 042 Chartreuse in Blick Studio, I'm going to put an all-over color. Let that dry, and then put another coat. Really like to get as much color variation out of a single marker as I can. Next, this is sort of blue green. Let that dry for a little bit, because when you work wet into wet, it blends more, which is fine, but details can get really fuzzy. So we're gonna start, we're gonna color in our mouth. This is Garnet R39. It might not be dark enough. I might have to go several layers, or I may have to switch over to a violet. We'll find out. So too light, gotta keep going. Definitely don't want the inside of someone's mouth to be lighter than the person's lips. I will, however, because it's a pretty color, sneak some of it into her lips, because why not? And while it's wet, let's go ahead and add dark umber, which is 049 in Blick Studio, but it's really not a dark umber. It's really more of a brick red. Maybe another layer of that and we'll be done. Next stop. And let that dry before we add Spanish olive, which is kind of a weird color. Might end up drinking a lot of mint tea tonight. And she has a little mole, and I think dark bark will work for that. So Spanish olive is kind of a good color for this because it makes it seem like her eyes have brown in them without me actually having to risk putting a brown in there. That would just like kill the color. Oh yeah, her mole. Way. All right, let's do hair. I like to work with dark warm grays for Naomi's hair, so, but you also want to leave room for highlights. So I'm going to do an all over color of W5 warm gray. And I know it makes her look like a weird young old person right now. Don't worry. It's not permanent. also kind of want to do a Naomi, at least one Naomi day, because I kind of did a Kara day in chapter 6. So it would be interesting to show sort of the juxtaposition between a human like Naomi and a Lilliputian like Kara and how they go about their daily lives. So I don't like the sharp angle her ear seems to be at. So I'm gonna grab my Sienna. No, other side. Brush side. Fix that by blending it a little bit. See, with color, you can really influence somebody's perception of forms just by darkening a color or lightening a color if you have that option. If you're doing like acrylic or oils, or you can apply white gouache, or hey, gouache in general, is more additive. But with markers and watercolor, unless you're pulling out like color pencils, it's one way. It's just going to get darker and darker. And yeah, I know some of you guys are saying you could use colorless blender. You can use blending colors, which are like very light, like the B00s, the R00s. Those would be considered blending colors. But you know, I feel like when you blend out that way, there's always a risk of the color getting weird on you, sort of like what we were getting with her shoulder. So, I mean, if it's something you really need to do, or if it's an area that doesn't matter, like you're painting rocks or something, or drawing rocks, whatever, you can do that. And with watercolor, you can lift out, but, you know, it's really never going to be quite the same as getting it right the first go around. But it's also important to make mistakes and try to fix them, and that way you learn ways to fix mistakes. You learn what works, what doesn't work, what you can do in a pinch, what's going to look better than leaving it as is. Okay, so we've got that all over warm gray 5. Now we're going to do warm gray 9, and we're going to do sort of a loose, like a curly pattern all over her hair, leaving areas of W5 still showing. And I like to use the warm grays because they feel like browns but tend to get a little darker than browns. And I usually try not to reach for black or special black unless I just have to. I did Day in the Life with Naomi. I would have to draw and design in school and draw and design a lot of other people. That's okay. That could be fun. And do it in watercolor. Ugh. It's hard handling large groups of people in tiny panels in watercolor. You can apply another layer of W9 if you want to, but I'm gonna go straight into W10. And the goal is to cover less ground with every pass, leaving highlights. That way it looks like there's light hitting different layers of hair.
Let me zoom in because it's a little hard to see.
This color palette definitely is like 80s Barbie doll, which is fine. I like it, and I like drawing in Naomi. I like drawing Naomi in these kind of colors too.
Whoa. Here we go. Alright, I'm going. Oh, yeah, that's right. Stupid me. Gotta do dumb eyebrows. Want to have a delicate hand with them. Can also go over the eyelashes. So they blend in a little bit better with the rest of the picture. Now, I want to use sardonyx, which I used earlier to like make the background a little bit darker, but I'm not seeing it. We might have to go with peach or coral. I wanted sardonyx. Or we could go with an obnoxious red violet, like begonia pink, which is kind of, it's not, I mean, it's very Barbie pink, if you know what I mean. Or we could even go with some really red violets. I think yes. Why not? Commit. We got a very 80s thing going here. Gotta commit. So we will start with Hollyhock. And it'll make all those purple splatters maybe look a little more on purpose. This is really gonna look 80s-tastic. So I'm gonna start with a harder to color area, the gathering on her top. I kinda wanna leave the pearls almost, I mean, I wanna do like a little hit of shadow maybe, and like a white highlight, and then just leave them as they are because they look kind of cool. And they don't look like pearls like that, but they look cool. And as artists, we have the option to decide that we want things to look cool over realistic. So gonna go on in and do another layer. This time, definitely indicating shadow. And we're using RV55 Hollyhock, a Copic color. I used to think I preferred one brand over another. I mean, I did all those alcohol marker tests, and Copic usually won. Copic's a pretty good marker. But, you know, there's just some colors that Copic doesn't do very well. And then Blick introduced their studio brush markers, which are pretty dang good.
and Prismacolor brush markers came out, and they have some really good colors. So for me, it's pretty much Copic, Blick, and Prismacolor. I do have some Winsor & Newton Pro markers and some Winsor & Newton brush markers. Not enough to do anything with, really. I have some Shinhan Twin Touches, which are pretty good. I like those. They're just kind of hard to find. All right, next up is Blick 004 Very Berry. Oh, that works really well with that, actually. And then RV66 Raspberry. Actually, that's the same color as Very Berry. Do I want to switch? Do I have anything that'll work? Maybe Peony. That lavalier mic means you guys get to catch every single time I mutter to myself weirdly. So I'm using RV69, which is Peony, and it is a Copic color. Although, I guess since we're not doing skin tone right now, you guys don't really need color racks, but I've kind of gotten in the habit of it, so, you know. All right, looking pretty good. So I want to use that blue I used earlier. Come on, there we go, B32. Sorry, that's me talking to my marker drawer. And nextly, we're going to need something that's going to work as a good shadow for the pearls. V12 might work. V06 might work. V05 might work. All right. Almost finished. Where are we? So pearls are pretty easy. You got your circle. So then you just pick a corner and consistently make a small circle in that corner. Basically, you want to do it away from the light source. Cut that all the way in. And with some of these, that shadow gets kind of lost, but I did grab some other violets. And y'all should be careful because while plum will stain your hand a little bit, not as bad as indigo. Ranger Indigo is just terrible about smearing and getting all over the place. And I'm kind of surprised I haven't heard any crafters complain about that. Maybe it's such a dark color that they don't use it very often. I've used it in a few of my illustrations as a spray. Especially like botanical kind of illustrations. These are so little that I don't know. I'm not going to do everyone. I'm just going to do a few. Because when I hit it with a little bit of white, it shouldn't matter. Because a lot of them have color on them anyway. All right, now V06, smaller dot. And this works for any unfaceted round gemstone type thing. Let's get way in there. Pull way out. Not actually way out, just out. I always need more promo art for Naomi anyway, so I need to be drawing her more, and she's fun to draw. I always forget that. Then, if you really need something dark, you can do a tiny spot with, is eggplant gonna be dark enough? Let's go with aubergine. Boy, didn't we just do this? Smallest dots. They look like little robin's eggs, don't they? That's kind of cute. I'm off camera when I'm that far down. Do you guys make weird slash stupid noises when you're markering or coloring? I, as you guys just heard, definitely do. I also sing myself stupid little songs if I'm by myself while I'm working. Guess I'm just entertaining a different part of the brain. Ah, all right, that looks pretty cool. So, next Illy. We're going to, I want to get like a very dark, cool gray. Oh, a very dark, cool gray for the irises on her eyes. And that's cute. I actually want to do a darker blue for the very tops. Oh no, ink blue, you are deceptive. You are darker than you look. This might be too though. All right, So a simple way to add white highlights is with a white Signo pen. Mine has decided to start acting up, which is not uncommon for Signo pens. So we're gonna try Signo first, and then if Signo doesn't wanna work, we're gonna switch over to gouache or Copic Opaque White. Just adding white highlights here and there. Unfortunately, it's a little bit of reflection for some reason. And for larger areas, like in this drawing, her hair, a brush pen, a brush with white gouache or white Copic Opaque White, or I guess you could even use white if you want, but it's not archival, but then neither are these, is a little bit easier than trying to, you know, add a bunch of little bitty white highlights with a Signo gel pen or a Sakura jelly roll, or, you know, your white gel pen of choice. And when you're adding the white highlight to those pearls, you want to add it in the opposite direction you applied your shadow. Add white highlight to some of the pearls on her dress. And you know what would be cute? And I don't know if this will work, and I don't know if it'll ruin it, but I think a white, like a bold white highlight around all of her would be pretty cute. So let's try it. Now doing this is going to flatten the image. So if that's something you care about, don't do this. But after I do this, I'm going to do something that's probably going to flatten the image even more. So I'm not too concerned. I finally got my signal going at full blast. Now, I'm not actually going to do it anywhere where it's going to cross over where I wrote her name. I am, however, going to add little highlights or whatever. Yeah. I can't believe that was running. All right, so what we've got is Copic Opaque White, a little container of water, a small synthetic brush, and we're gonna use this to mask again, even though it is, you know what, maybe not. What can I use? Because I just don't want to get it on her face. I don't really care. Oh, you know, I could use a post-it note. And I'll just sort of, well, I don't know about that, stress it a little bit so that it's not so straight. Just gently put one over her face. And this is just like post it on a note. I mean, dang it. Post-it on a roll. It's not actually Post-it brand, it's UB brand. But the brand doesn't really matter. I know, it looks really weird, right? Hopefully this will work out. So, you want to use a synthetic because it's got more bounce. Go ahead, stick it in the water first. And do this little tapping thing. And let's see, I think if you get more water, you're going to get more larger drops. And this is going to get everywhere. So just keep that in mind. You can cover your workspace with saran wrap. You can buy a craft mat like what I have here. This is an Ink Essentials craft mat. She's really got like that 80s Barbie thing going on. And it's kind of cute, but it's also really disconcerting because, like, I grew up in the 80s and I had 80s Barbie dolls. And the fact that she looks so much like, there's this particular one who had like this, not the most obnoxious hot pink color I've ever seen. Even as a kid, I was like, that is a dress. And now as an adult, I'm like, that was an ugly dress. I wanted to get those pink, those weird pink splotches out of her eye. They're fine on the skin, but on the eye, it makes her look like she's got pink eye or something, and that's not a cute look. Anyway, she looks so much like 80s Barbie, it's a little disconcerting, but that's fine. Sure, we'll roll with that. So, I hope you guys enjoyed another skin coloring tutorial. Got to put that back on. Silly lavalier mic, always forgetting it. If you enjoyed this video and you would like more like this, please make sure you leave a like. If you have any questions or comments, please leave me a, literally leave me a comment below and I will try to get to you as soon as I can. Sometimes it does take me a little bit longer. If there's anything specific you would like to see, let me know that as well. Sometimes, honestly, I forget what I've shown you guys and what I haven't shown you guys and what you, and I have, there's no way I can read your mind and just know what you want to see more of. And the reason I opted to do this tutorial today is because somebody commented that they'd like to see me do more people of color. And I mean, I have a couple of tutorials like that, but not nearly enough, not as many as I should. So, you know, that comment inspired me to make a video. So I benefit from having you guys make suggestions as well. And the person who left that comment was really super polite about it. You know, I would have been a jerk to refuse them. So if you want to see something particular, just try to ask nicely, you know what I mean? Like, cause I will probably try to do it for you. I want to grow. I want to help you guys grow. I want to give you guys the sort of videos you want to see. So this is something that we work towards together. If you really, really enjoyed this video, it would be a huge favor to me if you went ahead and shared it to your social media using those buttons down below the video. Or, you know, you can share it to your social media in whatever way that you feel comfortable doing so. I had somebody share it to their Instagram the other day, and I really, really appreciated that, especially because, like, it's a couple extra steps to share stuff to Instagram. You have to take a screen cap, and then you have to upload it and link it. And that's what they did. So I was really appreciative of that because, like, that was extra effort. But if you just click the buttons down below this video, you can more easily share this video to certain social networks. Twitter, Tumblr, Facebook, Pinterest, any of those are great places to share it, and it would help me out a whole lot. If you would like to help make more videos like this possible, head on over to my Patreon to join the community. My patrons get early access to videos, they get weekly updates, they get goodies. So if you head on over there, you can not only find out more information on how to join the community, you can find out what patrons get, and you can find out how the money is spent. It is spent, you know, creating more videos and more blog posts, buying art supplies to review, and equipment that makes the video quality better, like the lavalier mic that I'm wearing right now. It's not like I went out and bought a pony, although I could go out and buy a pony. Nah. But, you know, it all goes back into making more art education content like this. So, you know, joining the community is super appreciated. And yeah. Wow. I'm sorry. I'm tired. It's like 11 o'clock at night. It's night time. Anyway, one last place you can find more of my, well, you can find more of my work lots of places. You can check me out on Instagram at instagram.com/natosoup, but you can find more tutorials, tips, tricks, etc., and marker reviews, which I know you guys do care about, is by checking out my blog at natosoup.blogspot.com. 7 years worth of goodies on there and loads of marker reviews. So thank you guys so much for hanging out with me today. I hope you leave inspired. I hope I was able to answer some questions, or maybe inspire some new questions. I'm Becca Hilburn from Natosoup Studio. Bye, guys.